Welcome to the Jennifer Sheehan Show. I'm Jennifer. I would love to give you our digital magazine. Go to thejennifersheehanshow.com to subscribe. I'd love to introduce you to my friend Evelyn Molina and Nathan Molina. Great to have you both here.
Thank you. Great to. Thank nice you. To be here.
So, my gosh, I've known you for so long, girl. Like, at least, what, like 14, 15 years? Long time.
Yes.
Back when you were, how old were you?
Seven.
7 years old. Yes, ma'am. So Jared was like five, my son, and your kids were all young too. And I still remember when, with your baby, who's not a baby anymore, when you were pregnant with him.
I know.
So
time flies.
Yes, it goes by so fast.
Especially with all those kids.
Yes. So you have how many now?
Four.
What? Four? I just had one. That's all I can handle. Four boys is so amazing.
I love them. Yeah.
So where were you born and raised?
I was born in El Salvador, San Salvador, which is the capital for El Salvador. And I came here when I was 9 years old.
What was El Salvador like?
Oh my gosh, it was back in the 80s where there was war going on, and my dad was here living in the US. So it was my mom, my sister and I, and I'm the oldest one. So we were pretty much wake up in the morning and our bed would be shaken from bombs going off. And it got to the point that we sort of got used to that. We would come out the door and we see the army people running down the streets, you know. The next morning, sometimes there would be people that got shot in front of our house. So it was horrible. So
at such a young age, how old were you when you could remember all of that?
I was 9 years old when I came here. So I remember since like six, seven. Yep.
How scary was that?
It was horrible. It was horrible. You have no peace. I don't even know, you know, how we made it, but God is good. So
right?
He got us out of there. Yeah.
So you came to the United States to Houston.
Sure.
And what was Houston like coming from there?
Oh my gosh. So right away, my parents put us into the school system. Obviously, I did not know English.
How hard was that, not knowing English and being in school in America?
Bad. It was bad. But the good thing out of that is that there was other kids that spoke Spanish. But, you know, it was hard because I had to take classes just like any other kid that was in school. There was no preference because you didn't speak Spanish. So you had to be in the class and you had to pass in order for you to obviously move on to the next grade.
How do they treat you not speaking English?
Not good. As a matter of fact, every time we will speak Spanish among, you know, our friends, our peers, other kids that knew English would try to beat us up. So if we spoke Spanish, they will fight us.
Oh, I'm sorry you had to go through that. I'm sure there's so many people that are watching this show right now that have rather been through your same situation, that came to the United States and couldn't speak English. People that are dealing with that right now. What advice would you give them?
Hey, don't give up. give it all you have. What I did is I really started concentrated in learning English. So 6 months later, I was really doing good. I was put into an ESL class, which I'm pretty sure everybody knows what an ESL class is. And for those that don't know, it's English as a second language. So they put me in there, and I was trying to learn it so hard that, you know, like 3 months later or something, I was starting to speak English and I was being a translator for the other kids that were in there for my teacher and their parents. So, you know, when I got out of the ESL class, probably like a year later, I was even given a diploma for passing the ESL class.
Oh, so I love it.
That's how I started.
I love that. And then your family moved to Garland. What was Garland like?
Oh my gosh, I thank God they decided to move to Dallas, Texas. We went to Garland and we went to live with my aunt, and we lived in the garage. We lived in the garage. It was my mom and two of us, and we lived there, and my dad actually, so it was four of us there. And we went to school. I was already in the ninth grade, so it was high school. And when we got to the high school, a lot of people wanted to speak Spanish.
You're like, what the heck?
I was like, what's wrong with this, you know? So
different environment.
Different environment, more educated people. Sorry, but I love Houston, I do business. But it was like, you know, they really saw the the difference, I guess, in knowing two languages, right? So,
which I think is amazing. Better. I wish I could speak fluent Spanish. I know enough to get by, but I don't speak it fluently. So I think that's amazing. Do all your kids speak Spanish?
Definitely. I met him speak Spanish. And as a matter of fact, I put him in the ESL classes so they can learn Spanish.
I love that.
That's so funny that you had to go learn English
and they learn Spanish.
Exactly.
I love that. So your father was really strict, you mentioned, mm-hmm. And your friend's parents wanted to take you out to the club. Your father said, no way, but what'd your mother do?
My mother said, oh, let him go. She will always be on our side. You know, they're just going to the parents' house to have a good time. So there we went. He said, okay, fine, so.
And who did you meet?
So the mom took us out of the house and told my dad, oh, we're just gonna go ahead and have dinner at our house. And down a block down, she went home and we went to the nightclub with her daughters. And there I met their dad. I met him there at 17 years old. And from there's a story.
And you married him.
I married him at 17. Young, yeah. So I was going to school, I was a senior. And then I was married, you know, it was a little bit hard, but I knew I had to graduate from school to continue on my education. Right.
Then you went on to college to be an RN.
Yes, definitely.
And worked at the cable company.
Yes.
So some interesting things happened there. So here you are doing both. And actually, how old were you had your kids? So you had
Christian. Uh-huh. I was 21 years old.
Okay.
And then at 4 years later, I had Sebastian, my second son.
Right. And then now you were pregnant with your third son. Actually, while all this was happening.
Sebastian was 6 months old when I got pregnant with Tata, with Nathan.
I love it. So here you are pregnant with your third son, working at the cable company and going to college to be a nurse. You're like superwoman.
Oh, yeah, and I was in church serving. You know, doing all these ministries for the church.
You've always been that way though. You're always like, go, 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 go. I love it. So your husband at the time and your mom started working for a big janitorial company. And then you had a friend that owned a cookie company. And the cookie company, the owner told you, hey, we need help with cleaning because they knew your mom and your husband worked for a cleaning company. And you're like, okay. So what happened when you went in to clean?
So I went to my husband at the time and I asked him and I said, my friend wants us to clean. I said, but I don't have time. I mean, when am I gonna have time? And he says, oh, you know, we need to help your friend. So, yeah. Okay, so we decided to go and help. So while he was cleaning, I was sitting there at the table eating all these delicious cookies.
So he's cleaning?
With his big old belly eating cookies.
So he's cleaning and you're eating cookies.
Definitely.
I love it. When we come back, Evelyn gets a business miracle. We'll be right back.
The Jennifer Sheehan TV show is real people with real stories of redemption, miracles, and overcoming. This is a TV Christian show that gives God all the glory. The show is a 501c3 nonprofit, giving back 100% of donations towards the Jennifer Sheehan TV show. We also partner with Operation Care International, serving and supporting the homeless. In a world that is spreading fake hope, only Jesus Christ and the Holy Bible have the supernatural power to change people and their circumstances. Production for the Jennifer Sheehan TV show is extensive, and we need partners to keep it on air. If you believe in our cause, please prayerfully consider to be a partner for a $20 donation a month or more. May God bless you.
Welcome back to the Jennifer Sheehan Show. Okay, Evelyn, so you're eating cookies, pregnant. What happens with that cookie company?
So the cookie company liked the way we were doing the cleaning, the owner, so they asked us if we wanted to take over 6 more stores throughout DFW.
Wow, that is a huge business miracle that you were just handed this business. I mean, all you were doing was eating cookies. Your husband was doing all the work.
To this day, everybody asks me, remember when you started cleaning? And I say, I'm sorry, I never clean. So
you just boss the people around and eat cookies, right?
Exactly.
I want your job.
Even now, I'm like, don't ask me to clean. I just tell you what to do. I do know when it's dirty, though. So.
Right. I love that. So then what happens with the cable company that you're working for?
So my boss found out that we were cleaning the cookie bouquets, and she asked me, I hear that you have a cleaning company. And I said, on the weekend, nothing to do with my job, because I thought I was in trouble. Yeah. And she says, no, I hear you do a good job. So, you know, the people that clean here, we've gone through many companies and they don't do a good job. Would you be willing to give me a proposal and insurance? And if you do a good job, then I can give you, you know, this place right now. And then a month later, I can give you probably two more in Richardson. I said, sure, of course. I didn't know where to get this. So God is good. He got her assistant asked me, don't worry, I'll help you. So she told me where to call for insurance, how to do a proposal. So I was taken care of there.
And how many altogether in DFW did you end up getting?
So a month later, she calls me back in the office, and I'm thinking, oh my God, maybe she has complaints about the cleaning. And then she says, I want to talk to you about the cleaning you guys are doing. I said, sure. She says, well, everybody really loves what you're doing, you know, so we'll be willing to give you the DFW Metroplex to clean. I said, sure. And you know, I'm thinking maybe the three stores, she said. She goes, there's 18 of them.
Wow. So, how incredible is that?
Oh my God, it was incredible, scary, all right? Yeah. Because I mean, how do I go from 6 stores, 1 cable company, to 25 all of a sudden? Right. But you know, throughout that month that we were cleaning, even though I wasn't cleaning, you know, my husband and the dad was cleaning, I was their hero. Everyone would come by my office and stop and you know, and hooray that, you know, they like to clean it. So we took over the 18 stores, and obviously, first of all, I thank God, you know, for giving me the encouragement not to say no to business. Right. And then also my mom, because every time I came with business, she said, we can do it, let's do it.
You I know, love
so
your
that's
mom.
How that's how we grew our business. And
that
then
so
I had to
amazing.
Quit them to be able to, you know, take
right.
care.
So God tells you, RN or cleaning.
Yes.
And you believe that God was leading you to the cleaning business. So you stopped becoming an RN, did the cleaning company full time, and you're pregnant the whole time, 6 months pregnant with this handsome young man.
Yes.
So he's born. How many months were you pregnant when he was born?
He was born at 6 months,
wow.
24 weeks. He only weighed 1 pound and 6 ounces.
Wow, so he was born 1 pound, 6 ounces, 6 months, wow.
Can you tell?
Scary. how did you feel? I mean, well, first of all, I should say, what did the doctors tell you when he was born?
Well, keep in mind, he was this little. So if you want to kind of imagine how big 1 pound and 6 ounces is, about this big.
Wow.
I used to held him right here. Well, when he was in the hospital, the doctors, every time I would see their faces, they would always give me bad news. And they would say, I'm just here to tell you that your son will not make it. And I would say,
what'd you tell him?
Oh my gosh. I would say, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. And I would do this in their face. They thought I was crazy. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus because my son will live. And they'll be like, okay, yes, Miss Molina.
They would roll their eyes and just dust you off, huh?
Yes.
But guess what? Your son lived.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
I love it. I love it. And what a miracle he is, just to know that. Did they ever tell you what the odds were when a baby is born 1 pound, 6 ounces?
None. Maybe 1 to 0. They always told me that boys don't make it as wow. good as girls. And because he was a boy and he was that small, I mean, his lungs weren't really fully developed. They always told me that he was not going to make it. I never heard 1% or 1.5%.
Right.
I always heard he is not going to, but I didn't give up because they're not the ones that gave me my son. God did.
Right, right.
Amen.
And God says that the things that are impossible with man are possible with God.
Yes.
You stand on his word and
yes,
his promises.
Of course.
I love that.
And he never lies.
Absolutely. When we come back, Evelyn gets a Christmas miracle. We'll be right back. The Jennifer Sheehan magazine is both printed and digital and sent out to hundreds of thousands. The printed version of the magazine is strategically placed in local affluent businesses. The digital version is emailed, placed on social media, and promoted on the Jennifer Sheehan TV show every week. See digital magazine, packages, and prices at thejennifersheehanmagazine.com.
It is estimated that 26 million Americans have an organ-related problem. At any one time, there are over 100,000 people in the United States waiting for a life-saving organ transplant. I'm a walking miracle. 27 years ago, I was blessed with a perfect match for a heart transplant. But millions are not so lucky. A heart can only be kept for up to 6 hours before transplantation. This is where the David Nicklaus Organ Donor Awareness Foundation provides help. We offer free housing for those waiting for a life-saving transplant who travel to the Dallas-Fort Worth area, among many other life-saving measures. But most importantly, we offer love and compassion from a recipient's point of view for those waiting for their transplant. Please visit NicklausFoundation.org and learn how you too can spread love. Please join us and be a hero and help us save a life.
Running toilets waste water. Did you know the average running toilet wastes around 70,000 gallons every year? Visit BenjaminFranklinPlumbing.com to request an appointment.
A clean and disinfecting environment is essential. When I started 3 decades ago, I wanted to give my clients the same attention to detail as I gave my family. Today, we have over 200 staff members that follow the same philosophy. We are a one-stop shop for all of your cleaning needs. Please visit alljanitorial.net. Let us handle the mess so you can focus on what you do the best.
Welcome back to the Jennifer Sheehan Show. Okay, Evelyn, so you get a call from the hospital. What do they say to you?
So almost 3 months later, the doctors call me and say, you need to come to the hospital, bring a car seat so we can show you how to strap the baby in the car seat and how to show you how to use the breathing machine. So,
okay, because he's still pretty little, right?
He's still pretty little. He's on a breathing machine next to my bed. So,
and they had you spend the night at the hospital to show you how to take care of him?
Yes.
Which I would think would be a little bit scary, taking care of a baby that's that little.
Oh, yes.
How old was he then when they were, or not, I shouldn't say how old, but how little was he still at that time?
I think he gained from where he was one pound and 6 ounces. I think he gained to like 3 pounds, close to 4 pounds. Okay. Other than that, they will not let you have him go home.
Okay, so like 4 pounds,
mm-hmm.
Which is still pretty little.
Very little. Yeah.
Wow. So they show you how to take care of him, and then they help you secure him in the car seat. And this was in December.
Yes.
And they said you couldn't take him home until January.
Yes.
So what happened when they helped you secure him in the car seat?
So a few days earlier, the doctor says, I need you to bring, you know, the car seat, and we're going to show you how to strap him, because when you take him home in January, you need to make sure you know what you're doing. So here we are the following day after we spend the night at the hospital. So he's showing us, my mom was always there with me, thank God. And so she's showing us on how to strap the baby, and the nurses are here, the doctor's here, so we have the baby in there. So I'm just looking at him, and this was December 22nd when we're doing this.
Right.
And then he picks up the baby and he says, I think you stopped him right. And he hands me the car seat and he says, Merry Christmas. That is when I knew God is good, because yeah. We knew we were going to have a hard time during Christmas, you know, not having our baby there.
Yeah.
And we probably wouldn't have even had Christmas. We probably had to be at the hospital. So that was my biggest Christmas gift.
Christmas
from
miracle.
My Lord. Aww. And Savior, Nathan.
I love that. Yeah. And how tall are you now?
I am 6'1".
6'1"?
Yes,
and
ma'am.
How much do you weigh now?
250 pounds.
Wow. So from 1 pound, 6 ounces, to this handsome, strong kid. Well, I shouldn't say kid. You're a kid to me, but you're a man now. Even though I've known you since you were like this big. Mm-hmm. But wow. And then you have three brothers.
Yes, ma'am.
What are their names? Because you know you have to say their names or they're not going to be happy because they couldn't come on the show with you.
Yes, ma'am. Oldest, Christian. Second oldest one, Sebastian. And then the younger one, Gabriel.
The baby. Mm-hmm. Oh, I just love it. I love your family. Just love
Thank
your
you.
Family.
I love you too.
So everything is good on the family side. You got your baby home. Everything's great. Then your business is just booming. And now all these years later, how many employees do you have?
So back in 1992, we started with three. My mom, my ex-husband, and moi. Eating cookies. 28 years later now, we have over 200 employees, and we now service throughout Texas, Oklahoma, Texarkana.
Wow. And what kind of services do you do now? I know you've added services over the years.
Sure. We have the whole realm of construction services, commercial services, and also maintenance services.
I love it. What is your website so people can get a hold of you?
Sure. It's www.alljanitorial.net. Alljanitorial.net.
I love that. So tell me why your business has been so successful.
So everything we do, and we do it very well, is because of God. So if it wasn't because of Him, this business would not exist. So I give Him the honor and the glory. He's the only one that can do this for us.
I love that. When I just look at all the miracles and everything that God's doing, and you know, so many people in life in general will say, and they've told me this my whole entire career, that you should not mix religion and business. And you know, that's the one thing that you and I have had in common for all these years. And that's not always made me popular. I mean, having a marketing company, a magazine, I had a radio show, and now a TV show. Well, it just happens to be a Christian TV show now.
Sure.
But before it wasn't. And the magazine was not Christian. And so that's all changed now. But that didn't always make me popular. So knowing that Jesus Christ is the rock of my business, when people see me going from a hard childhood and going from the United States Army to now having my business for 20 years, and it just growing and growing and getting bigger. And people ask me all the time, how? Like, how are you successful? How did this happen? I'm like, it is nothing but God. He gets all the glory.
Yeah.
So the same thing with you. I mean, what tips would you give people from where you've gotten from then till now?
Sure. First of all, I want to say it's because it's not a religion company. It's Jesus Christ. It's the I Am that we serve, that we are good for, because, you know, He's in the center. So what I will recommend to people is, you know what, just if you trust God, He says that if you trust in the I Am, then He will just lead you to the path that He has for you already. So don't listen to negativity, just pray about it. And if it's God's will, He will take you there, and He will put the right people in your path and the right clients. And clients that really don't need to be in your company, He will also do away with.
Yes. You know, one of my prayers with this show is I'm like, okay, God, this is your TV show. You gave me the show. Whoever is supposed to come on the show, yes, let them come on. Whoever's not, my favorite prayer, shut the door, lock it, and do not let me go through it. Why? Because God knows what we don't know.
Exactly.
People can fool us. They cannot fool Him.
Amen.
He's the only one with the supernatural power to change our situations in a snap of the fingers.
Definitely.
The only one. So it's interesting. If He knows what we don't know, mm-hmm, and He has supernatural power, we have none, why wouldn't we let Him guide and direct every situation, not just in our families, but in our business?
Life, business, yeah, family.
You know, definitely. And that's what's been always my favorite thing about you, is that from day one, from me knowing you, you were all about serving and tithing and putting God first and your family. And that's actually a lot to juggle. I mean, have you ever looked back and thought, oh my gosh, I've accomplished a lot?
I do every now and then. I'm like, oh my
God. When you
God.
Stop for a minute and you're like, wow, what did I do?
And
same
raising
thing.
Four boys at the same time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I only had one, but I'm thinking that was a lot of work too. I mean, just to be a business owner and a mom is a lot to juggle, but I mean, it's proof that you can do it all, and you can have it all when Jesus Christ is the rock of your family and the rock of your business. You're a blessed woman.
Amen. Thank you. And I thank God, and you know, He gives us health, because without health, we cannot do all these and do everything else we do. So I honor Him, I glorified Him, and just out of many, many miracles, but the one right here. I mean,
which is the most important family.
Most important family. He saved my baby's life, Nathan. And I prayed and I said, Lord, if you're going to give me Nathan, let him live and he will serve you. And here he is. He's got a great heart. Everyone loves Nathan.
So love you,
God has a miracle. God has something for him. So he's going to be a radiologist for Premise. So that's what he's going to school for.
I love
it. He's going to give back to those Premise.
Thank you so much for coming on. I appreciate it so much.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
When we come back, you can also have a miracle.
A professional cleaning company can save you time and give you peace of mind, ensuring that your staff members and loved ones are safe. In a clean and disinfecting environment is essential. When I started 3 decades ago, I wanted to give my clients the same attention to detail I gave my family. Today, we are over 200 staff members that follow the same philosophy. In every category of service we offer, commercial cleaning, construction final cleaning, high-rise window washing and power washing, hospitals, ISDs, and more. We see you as a partner. We make it as easy as possible for you for all your cleaning needs, 24/7, including nights and holidays. For more information and specials, please visit alljanitorial.net. Let us handle the mess so you can focus on what you do the best.
One of the worst days of my life was when I was told that my 7-year-old twin son Johnny had cancer. Over 300,000 children are diagnosed with cancer every year. The Kids Shouldn't Have Cancer Foundation is determined to end pediatric cancer. Your gift of $15 a month will give these kids a voice they deserve.
Just if you see this video, thank you. Because I'm just a kid.
Welcome back to the Jennifer Sheehan Show. Our God is the God of miracles. If you haven't prayed to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, pray with me. Jesus, I know you died on the cross for my sin. You rose on the 3rd day. Please forgive me for my sin. I receive you as my Lord and Savior. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Tune in next week. We have another incredible story for you.